everyone. Welcome back to 996. The Howl, three games in the books at Mullett Arena. They finally get the first victory against the Florida Panthers, winning 3-1. A couple elite Eastern teams coming into Tempe with the Rangers and the Panthers, and the fact that both games were pretty much one-goal games, tight games, competitive. The Coyotes were hanging around, whether good or bad. Stellar performances by Ingram and Vemelka. It's great having a tandem that kind of motivates each other. And, you know, once one goalie sits on the bench for one game, he wants to get back out there for the next game and show that they could rely on him as a goalie and outperform his partner. So it's a good relationship there. Sort of like what we saw with Wedgwood and Vemelka last season. But, you know, I have higher hopes for Ingram than Wedgwood, but a great set of games here. All three games at Mullett Arena have been one-goal, tight games, competitive losses for the Coyotes and the win against Florida. And if the Coyotes are going to lose games, I'd rather they lose games like Winnipeg and like the Rangers at home. It gives the crowd a good experience. They get to walk home or take the light rail home now and just gush about the game and how much fun they had. When you're a fan and you're in a game for 58, 55, maybe the 60 minutes in overtime, you're in it cheering for your team, you feel really good, as opposed to, you know, the game's over after 10 minutes because they get blown out or, you know, they just dig themselves an early hole. So it's great that for this four-game homestand, it's exactly what I wanted. Competitive losses to help the tank, but also show some steps forward and some growth in their system and the players, and the crowd's getting just that. It was a bit of an emotional night with Hockey Fights Cancer. You know, the team's had a lot of close deaths with cancer in Matt Schott and Accardo. Always forget her first name. But, you know, both of them in the Ring of Honor. I know there's no Ring of Honor at Mullett Arena, but for their next arena, hopefully they will be on the Ring of Honor. Let's get into the game. I thought the Coyotes started this game off perfectly. They finally have put to bed those terrible starts where they're down 2-0 or 3-0 early. That was happening earlier in the season on that Eastern road trip. But lately, the Coyotes have been having really good first periods, maybe dictating the pace or starting on time, maybe due to the time zone change, the more comfortable playing, you know, at a start time that's accommodating for living in Arizona. But thought they started off really good. You know, Gunther hit a post on a 2-on-1. They had a really nice looking power play early. It was just a great first 10 minutes. And then near the end of the first, it kind of got away from them. They had a power play, but it was pretty bad. And then Florida just turned it on and started peppering Vemelka with shots. That continued into the second period where I thought Florida just took over the game in that second period. They had to rely on Vemelka a lot. Vemelka had a big save on Hornquist on a breakaway. It was just like Florida just taking so many shots on Vemelka. At the end of the game, Florida had over 80 shot attempts. And they finished the game without over 40 shots. And the fact that Vemelka only allowed one goal, pretty remarkable. And then finally, near the end of the second period, Coyotes find the netting on the power play. Lawson Kraus from Michelli and Gunther. And we've been saying from Michelli and Gunther a lot on power play goals lately. All of Michelli's points have been on the power play. Great to see Gunther get another point. He's got 6 points in 8 games played. He has one more game, which is Thursday night against Dallas. That will be his 9th game in the NHL. And then the decision has to be made by the organization if they want to keep Gunther up or send him back down to junior. Sending him to the American Hockey League for Tucson is out of the question. It is not allowed if the player plays junior hockey in Canada. So it's either, you know, the juniors in the Western Hockey League or he stays on the NHL. It's a tough decision. I was always thinking, you know, they're going to send Gunther down after 9 games, but I mean, he's producing. He has an impact on the game. He looks comfortable. He looks energized. It's exciting to watch Gunther and even Michelli form a chemistry. And even sometimes Gunther's on the top line with Keller and he doesn't look out of place. I just think he needs to grow into his body a bit more. He looks a bit small. He's a bigger guy, so he needs to fill out. But you know, as he gets older, that's going to happen. He's only 19, but I like that he's making it a tough decision for the organization. I don't know which way the organization is going to go. If he's too good, it kind of hurts the tank. That's one of the negatives. But at the same time, if he's producing at the NHL and playing well, you know, why not? What else is he going to do in juniors? I know he was injured for the Memorial Cup last season for his WHL team, but that's pretty much all he has to do is, you know, get back to the Memorial Cup and help them win. But I think maybe it's better for him to stay on the team. It's just a tough decision. I'm glad I'm not making it because, you know, if he plays too well and he starts winning new games, like, the goal of this season is to get that highest draft pick. So it's a tough decision. Like I said, I'm glad I'm not making it. But Michelli, too. It's a joy to watch Michelli. He looks like Keller in Keller's rookie year, but just like a bit less skilled. I mean, the fact that he's got no points on 5-on-5 is a bit troubling, but the way he carries a puck, makes plays, he's just really fun to watch, and he's kind of coming out of nowhere. I know I used to watch his highlights in Finland, but he's not like a highly touted prospect. He's just a prospect we had laying around from the John Chyka era, sort of like Jan Janik. And we're just seeing what he's made of. And it seems like every game, Michelli's getting a bit better, which is an improvement from last season where he started off really strong and then disappeared for a long period of time. So it's great that, you know, we're starting to see the growth in Michelli. He's confident. He's making plays. He's running around out there, too. He's a small guy, but he's not afraid to go into the corners and throw his body, even if he falls after getting hit. So it was 1-0 at the end of the second, and just like the end of the first, Florida was starting to turn it on at the end of the second. We go into the third period. Florida hits the post. They have the momentum. They had 16 shots in the second. They finished the third period with 19. But, you know, Coyotes get a power play. It was 1-1 at the end of the second. Should say that. Yes. So in the third period, Nick Ritchie gets a game-winning goal on a power play. Assisted by Moser and Keller. Great to see again Moser getting another point. You know, I was talking about this in a Discord during the game. The two draft picks that Bill Armstrong has drafted and have played on the Coyotes for like extended periods of time. I know we had Ben McCartney for a little bit last year, but to be solidified on the team now is Moser and Gunther, and they're both making a huge impact on the team. Moser's just a steady defenseman. They're throwing him on the power play, keeping him on the penalty kill in all situations. He's a horse. They ride him a lot, and he's getting better as his career extends. He could be, like, you know, a good replacement for Chychrun once they decide to move on from him. I know they need a bit of a more offensive defenseman, but in all situations, Moser's really good. I'm liking him. You know, he's starting to become one of my favorite players, so hopefully he signs a long extension and Bill Armstrong doesn't trade him. But, you know, after the goal Nick Ritchie scored, Florida continued to pour it on. There's a lot of heat and emotion and desperation near the end of this game. There's a missed call on O'Brien where Tkachuk slashed O'Brien. Andre Tourney, the head coach, got really heated and passionate. Haven't really seen that from him in the past season and couple weeks here he's been with the Coyotes, but a very scrummy and heated end to the game. And, you know, I mentioned this in the first video against the first game in Pittsburgh. These two teams, there's no bad blood, there's no rivalry. They're from opposite ends of North America. It shouldn't be this heated, but it shows me that the Coyotes are really hard to play against and frustrating to play against. Not hard that they're really good and skilled, just you have to, if you're the opposing team, you have to show up and have to play your game if you want those 2 points. You can't sleepwalk through this team. They're competitive, they're hard-hitting, and they'll make you work for it. Most of the times, you will win that game, but you just have to earn it, and the Coyotes aren't really a freebie on the calendar. They're a desperate hockey team, it seems like, and they want to show that they deserve to be in this league. They're not leaving the league, but they deserve to be an NHL team and push teams to their limits to get those 2 points. So, you know, the goaltending has been keeping us in these games. I'll admit that. The expected goals for last night for Florida was over 6. So it should have been like a 6-3 game. in terms of analytics, but, you know, Vemelka and Ingram are standing tall. They're making the big saves, and they're giving the team a chance. They're weathering the storm, and the team is taking those chances that the goalies are giving them and finding ways to keep the games competitive and stay in the game and make it a good hockey game to watch. Keller got the empty netter, assisted by Fisher. First win at Mullett Arena. It was just a really good game all around. Like I said, the special teams, the power play was 2-for-4 last night. They're third in the league on the power play, and they're at 82.4% on the penalty kill, which is sixth in the league on the penalty kill. So special teams are crazy. I know 5-on-5 has to be way better, but really, really excited that special teams are like top half in the league and top 10 in both those categories. Last year, both those metrics were down in the dumps near the bottom of the league. And one of my expectations for this season was to have a better penalty kill. And it seems like John Madden is having his way with the penalty kill. They look better. They're clogging the middle of the ice. They're not, you know, dysfunctional on the penalty kill. The power play, too. I know I've mentioned Gunther and Michelli already, but their power play is so exciting to watch. And it's been so long since we've seen a really good power play by the Coyotes. So hopefully these things keep going. I know maybe for sure over 30% on the power play is unsustainable. That's going to come back down to earth. But hopefully at the same time, their 5-on-5 play starts to get better. They're last in the league in 5-on-5 shots and expected goals for. So that's got to get some work. And they got one more game at Mullett Arena against Dallas. And then they're on the road for one of the longest road trips in NHL history. 14 games. That's going to be crazy. Maybe that helps the tank. You know, when you're on the road trip for so long, you're not expected to put on a good performance like you would if you're playing at home like they have these past three games. So it'll be a bit forgiving if they start to slide a bit because they're on the road. But, you know, after these first four games at Mullett Arena, hopefully the Dallas game Thursday is good as well. But that's about like 4 or 5 weeks where the Coyotes are on the road and the fans in Tempe and all around the valley can spread some good word and goodwill about their experience at the arena and generate some hype for when they come back from that long road trip and they, you know, they're there, they show up for the team when they come back from a long road trip in open arms and cheer them on, and it just generates excitement. So hopefully just one more game, they can make it a good competitive game. You don't have to win, just make it a good experience and a good hockey game and just generate some momentum going into the road trip and generate momentum for fans to show up near the end of November, beginning of December when they come back from that long roadie. So that's it for me. It's been a really good start to the season. I know the first couple games were a bit rough to watch, but compared to last season, this team is looking like peak Andre Tourigny hockey, which we saw right before Keller's injury. I feel like late January, February, and March, the Coyotes were really good to watch and a good hockey team. They're good, doing the good things, and that's what we're seeing in these first 9 games. And, you know, if you're on Team Tank, you might not like to see these overtime losses and wins, but it's great hockey to watch. It's exciting to watch. You get up for every game and you're thinking, oh my God, they have a chance to win this. It's pretty fun hockey, entertaining, and that's really all you want as a fan. So that's it for me. Thank you for watching. If you like what you see, spread the word. And as always, thank you for your support.